In this video, we'll see about this flags for follow-up. Now what exactly it says, suppose if you have created any item, maybe a defect, a requirement or a test case, and you want a reminder or you need a follow-up for that. So you can keep a follow-up for at least 1 week, 1 month or 1 year. Whenever there's a due date, an email will be sent to your email box and you can get a reminder. So based on the reminder, you can take some action on that. So let us see practically how do we work on this flags for follow-up.
Now, flags are visible in the indicator columns. If you see, right now I'm in the defects. And if you see, these are the flags which are mentioned here. That is a flag. Now, sometimes if I want to remind myself, I'll be using this flag option. So what I'll do is, I'll select this number 7 over here, the defect number 7. And I'll simply click on this flag for follow-up. If I click on this flag for follow-up, this is today's date, followed by 5/30/2017. That's today's date. And I'll just mention it, try to solve by today, before this day, and I'll click on this OK button. Before some date I can give it, 1st of June, and I'll click on OK. So when I put a flag which is follow up by today itself, today's date is 30th of May, and if I click on OK, so now if you observe, if you put a flag of today's day, it will become a red color flag, and email will be sent to a person who has written this defect. This is one flag and follow up. But suppose if you select this particular defect here and if you put a flag for follow-up, and now this is today's date, if I enter some other date, let's say 2nd of June 2017, and here if I write some description, let's say as follow-up defect, and if I click on OK, when I click on OK, observe the color of this flag will be something else. This is the gray color. So whenever the day has come, the due date has come, the color of the flag will become as red color. If the due date has not yet come, it will be gray color. When the due date has come, an email will be sent to a person who has written this defect, and he'll be getting a reminder of this. It's nothing but nothing known as flag for follow-up. If I keep my cursor here, it is flag for follow-up. Now, this is not only available in defects, but it is also available in the test lab. If I click here, go to view menu bar, here itself. Here, if you see, there's a flag. I can just select from here the flag for follow-up. If I go to test plan, even here I can see that. But I'll select this particular test case and I can select this flag for follow-up. If I go to requirements, select this requirements menu bar, that's a tab here. And then here also I'll be having as flag for follow-up. So anywhere, any place if you go, flag for follow-up is a very important tool to give you a reminder, send an email notification to follow up whatever things have been pending here. So I hope you have understood how to work with flags and follow-up. That's all for this video.